This past summer, I got on a plane with 24 other North Carolinians and traveled to San Pedro Sula, the second largest city in the Central American Republic of Honduras. We had a difficult time recruiting people to embark on this adventure with us because a simple Google search will tell you that Honduras is an incredibly dangerous place and one of the poorest countries in the entire world. What we found when we got there, however, was a country ready to embrace us and abundantly wealthy in beauty, culture, and history. Welcome to San Pedro Sula, the murder capital of the world. I'm in beautiful Honduras today. Honduras is an amazing country with an incredible history. Thousands of years ago, indigenous groups carved out complex civilizations in the middle of rainforests and the mountains. The Maya built one of the most impressive cities in the western part of the country in what's known as Copan. More recent history involves European influence. The name Honduras is said to go all the way back to Columbus himself when he landed here nearly 500 years ago. The ensuing clash of cultures between Westerners and the indigenous people here is nothing short of a war of the worlds. When the Spanish conquistadors arrived, the indigenous people of Honduras mounted a massive resistance movement. This movement is embodied in the persona of one man himself, the Lenca Lempira. Today, Lempira is celebrated as a national hero and symbol of Honduras, with his face on t-shirts and their national currency. I sat down with three Honduran students to get a better idea of who Lempira was and is.
I want you to tell me the story of Lempira that you heard when you were a kid in school.
Oh, okay. So he was like one of the bravest Hondurans that has ever been.
And Lempira was an Indian who fought and died for the independence of Honduras.
That's one of the characters we're most proud of. He fought for us against colonization.
Lempira was an Indian who fought for our rights when Spanish came to conquer us.
He just wanted like freedom here. He wanted Honduras to stay as the Honduras it was before Spaniards came here. They say, well, I've heard that he died because of betrayal. And I've heard also that he died because some Spaniards killed him.
Wow, they say there's stabbing on the back.
So who is Lempira now?
Now? Mm-hmm. He's just like a national hero.
He really set an example for us. He was brave, he loved our country, he loved our nation, and he was not afraid of what will happen to him. He was just so in love with Honduras that I bet giving his life for this nation wasn't like, wasn't something that maybe bothered him.
So pretty much Lempira for me is a hero because he fought for us at the beginning.
The struggle against Western influence has continued into the 20th and 21st century. The term Banana Republic was actually coined by North Carolina writer O. Henry to describe this country. Oh, banana, banana, si te gusta la banana. Banana companies became a massive giant in terms of policy and economics in Honduras, dominating the country for generations. The legacy of Western influence continues in Honduras to this day. It's one of the poorest countries in the Western Hemisphere, and it's one of the most dangerous countries in the world because of drug violence. In 1931, Honduras renamed its currency the Lempira, which embodies the idea of Hondurans taking ownership of their own country away from Western imperialists. Now, Hondurans are working with people all over the world to make a better Honduras. You don't have to take my word for it. Come see for yourself.
Go for an action!
Stablo.
Right.
Ay, ay, ay!
I will turn to the window and you will physically come this way.
I don't want to do that. I think I'll hand it to you and you can do it.
It'd be really funny if Bob got scored on in his own video.
Okay, I'll come to the window. Alright, ready?
Yeah, hold on.
Oh, I'll...
I think I'm not sure.
It's a gas station. It's a gas station. Yeah, I keep a few things.
Champion sound. Yeah, I got a few rings. That's all I know. And you can stay up.
And if you ask anybody where I live. Okay, perfect.